There's another BP rig in the Gulf in the spotlight. It is called the Atlantis, the second largest oil rig in the Gulf, bigger, deeper than the Deepwater Horizon, one of the most complex deepwater platforms in the world. A former BP contractor and at least 24 U.S. lawmakers say there's reason to believe the Atlantis may be unsafe. Joe Johns tonight is investigating.
122 miles off the Louisiana coast in deeper water and able to pump more oil than Deepwater Horizon ever did sits BP's monster of an oil rig. They call it Atlantis. It runs on technology some say rivals the space shuttle, but when you ask for the engineering documents, the blueprints, the schematics, the drawings that show you how to put this thing together, you'll get a surprise. 90%, that's right, 90% of the safety documentation for Atlantis was missing as of the end of 2008. That's according to the advocacy group Food and Water Watch, which got the information from a BP project supervisor turned whistleblower. The group says Atlantis is an accident waiting to happen, and they're in court seeking an injunction claiming Atlantis needs to be shut down now because in an emergency, no one would know how to.
And in a production facility as sophisticated as BP Atlantis, there are millions of components, moving parts, that the operator needs to know where they are to turn it on, to shut it off in case of an accident. And it's outrageous that 90% of the safety documentation is missing.
The whistleblower himself is scheduled to testify for Congress this week. And last month, 24 members of Congress sent a letter to the administration asking for the rig to be shut down.
Well, why can't you just go out to the rig, look around, and see if everything's in order or not?
Well, for one thing, the BP Atlantis goes 7,000 feet into the sea and then even deeper into where the oil is. So a lot of these components aren't visible from the platform.
BP says reports claiming it's operating with incomplete or inaccurate engineering documents aren't true, and that operators on the platform had access to up-to-date drawings needed to run the platform safely. BP says it's done 2 investigations into those assertions and says it's nothing more than a minor internal process issue that has no bearing on the safe operation of the platform. Internal emails suggest that as far back as 2008, BP knew it had a problem. One employee said BP had incomplete drawings of the rig's internal structure, but BP worried that turning such documents over to people who have requested them could lead to what one official called catastrophic operator errors because they would assume they were correct. And why doesn't the Interior Department step in and shut down Atlantis while BP gets its paperwork in order? The press secretary for the department said they could not comment because the matter is under litigation. But in a court filing, Interior Secretary Ken Salazar said the investigation of claims about Atlantis should be done by mid-September. Joe John, CNN, Washington.
Interesting. Joe is following some other stories for us tonight. He joins us with a 360 News and Business Bulletin. Joe?
Anderson, a Colorado man is in police custody in Pakistan tonight for trying to hunt down Osama bin Laden. Pakistani officials say Gary Brooks Faulkner was picked up near the Afghan border carrying a pistol, sword, and night vision goggles. Police in Aruba and Peru are pledging to join forces in the murder investigation of a college student whose battered body was found in Joran Vandersloot's Lima hotel room June 2nd. Investigators hope the cooperation will lead to new information about the disappearance of Alabama teenager Natalie Holloway 5 years ago in Aruba. Vandersloot was twice arrested, but never charged in that case. Customers eager for the latest iPhone faced huge setbacks today in their quest to pre-order that gadget. Online systems, as well as those at Apple and AT&T stores, crashed repeatedly. The new smartphone will be in stores June 24th. And you're looking at the charred remains of what was once a 62-foot tall statue of Jesus in Monroe, Ohio, near Dayton. An apparent lightning strike last night sparked the fire, which spread to a church amphitheater. And this is what it looked like. There you can see it there. They used to call it Touchdown Jesus, but now it's being called Terminator Jesus. And I guess that's why they call a lightning strike an act of God, Anderson.
Wow, sad news that. Joe, thank you very much. Still ahead, a baby bird found dead, bird eggs crushed, a nesting site that people here say may have been destroyed by cleanup workers. Story coming up. Also ahead, the culprits of the catastrophe. We are naming names, see who we're adding to our list tonight. Welcome back. We're live in Louisiana. I want to show you something. We've obtained photos taken recently by members of the Plaquemines Parish Inland Waterways Strike Force of a brown pelican nesting site in Queen Bess Island. Now, I want to warn you, for some, these photos are going to be tough to look at. You can see a chick lying dead in a nest. Nearby eggs that have been crushed. Local officials say that crews sent by BP to clean up the area are responsible for this kind of destruction. They say the workers are walking on the nest, being careless with their equipment. For wildlife rescue groups, these photos underscore the urgency that they be made part of the cleanup operation. Gary Tuckman has an up-close look.
Deep into Louisiana marshland, searching for pelicans and gulls struggling to survive.
There are thousands of birds just in this one location, one small barrier island in the Gulf of Mexico. At any time, every one of these birds could plunge into the water to get a fish and end up mired in oil.
And that's what Michael Carlos with the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries is looking for.
You see a little opening in that grass? I think he's sitting right in there.
We then see it too, a baby seagull drenched in oil, barely moving. The gull is one of more than 600 visibly oiled birds that have now been rescued in Louisiana since this oil disaster occurred and brought for cleaning and care to a center that has been opened in Plaquemines Parish, Louisiana. The bird we have spotted is being rescued by state wildlife workers. Other birds are rescued by federal wildlife workers. However, there are many other bird experts and enthusiasts who want to participate in rescues, but are being told at this time by the state and federal agencies they are not interested in help from outsiders. Drew Whelan from the American Birding Association says there are hundreds of people from other parts of the country experienced in dealing with birds covered with oil.
I cannot see any reason why they would not want as many people here as possible.
The Humane Society of the United States agrees, the president of the organization saying, "We need more trained personnel on boats working in the Gulf, and we need more boats deployed to search in a more systematic way for the animals in distress."
Throw me some gloves.
But the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries says, "We have the resources to handle the job at hand at this time. The volunteers who have offered services simply need to be ready to respond when the call comes, when that time comes."
I think the misconception may be that we're not doing our best. And, you know, I would argue that our field staff is doing their absolute best.
State officials say even if they haven't dealt with oil spills, they know their birds and their birds' habitats. Plus, they say almost all boat and housing resources are being used.
It's a chick, too. You'll see it's a... Yeah, it's...
As our baby seagull is handed over for cleaning, we don't know for sure if it'll survive. What we do know for sure is that there is plenty of disagreement about the rescue operation and that there are many more birds that need to be saved. Gary Tuckman, CNN, Grand Isle, Louisiana.